In this video, we're going to explore the first tool in the ACPF toolbox, where we get to develop our fill DEM, a flow direction and flow accumulation roster, as well as a hill shade. So let's jump right in. All right, so the first thing we're going to run is the D8 terrain processing tool. We go into our ACPF toolbox, into the stream network development tool set, and open up the first one. This requires two inputs, your unfilled DEM and a Z factor. The other four are outputs. We can drag our unfilled DEM into here. You see the other outputs have been automatically populated. In my case, my XY units are in meters and my Z units are in centimeters. So my conversion factor will be centimeters divided by meters, therefore 0.01. To run the tool, we hit OK. The first of the four outputs was the filled DEM, where sinks in the landscape are filled so water can continually flow downhill. You can see in this example, we have a sink, and then after the process, it is filled in. So water that flows that previously would have flown into that sink will not be trapped. In the DEM shown below, you can see flow paths that are disconnected because they flow into sinks shown in green. But once they've been filled, these flow paths are now connected to the mainstream network. The second output is the flow direction roster. This uses the D8 approach and then assigns a number code based on the direction that the water will flow. For example, if the water is going to flow east based on the change in elevation, a number code of 1 will be assigned to that cell. You can see in the square below that 1 is east, 4 is south, 16 is west, and so on. This will be used to generate the flow accumulation roster. The third output is the flow accumulation roster, which uses the flow direction roster to calculate how many upstream cells flow into a given location. In the output flow accumulation roster, the value at each grid cell is equal to the number of upstream cells that flow into it. In the below image, we can view this flow accumulation roster to see where we begin to have concentrated flow paths. For example, as more upstream cells begin to converge, we can see those concentrated flow paths in green. And then the more that the flow is converging, the darker the color, eventually turning blue. This allows us to view flow paths throughout the watershed and begin to estimate where a channel may begin. Behind this flow accumulation roster in yellow, we can also see our fourth output, which is the hill shade. The hill shade will mostly be used for visualization purposes and to understand our terrain's characteristics. So once the D8 terrain processing tool is finished running, the outputs are automatically added to the map document. First, I can see my hill shape, but I'm just going to turn that off for now. Next, we see my flow accumulation, which isn't showing us too much. And third, we see the D8 flow direction roster, which looks absolutely crazy. And then we have that filled DEM output, which at the moment looks just like our original DEM, though the sinks have been filled. So I'm going to turn these off and go back to my flow accumulation roster for a second. Right now we're not seeing much, but with some visualization, we'll be able to see a whole lot more. So we'll go into the properties. You can get there by right-clicking or double-clicking. Go into the symbology tab, and you can see that right now we're on stretched. We're going to add some color, and then go down to stretch type. Here I recommend going with standard deviation or histogram equalize. I'm going to go with histogram equalize. And then for stats, we want to change to it from current display extent. Hit apply. Okay. We'll notice that if we zoom in, that the display will change, and that's what that from current extent is doing. So the further we zoom in, the more flow paths start to appear. And this background is still yellow because that is going to indicate our lowest value. Another way we can visualize the flow accumulation roster is by going to the classified. Here we want to change our number of classes to 2. Hit classify. And I want to be able to show 1 acre of flow accumulation. I know that my DEM has a 2 meter resolution, and therefore each cell is 4 square meters. And there's about 4,000 square meters in 1 acre. So I'm going to change my lowest value to 1,000 cells. Hit OK. Apply. Okay. This lowest value, I'm going to make transparent. Color is null. Okay. And I'll make this a bright color that'll show up. And now we can start to pan around and you will be able to see everywhere that flow accumulation paths are going to be generated. We can turn on our hill shade underneath it to really start to visualize these flow paths. Here's a brief recap of what we just did. Next up, we'll be able to start an iterative editing process using these layers.